Golden, out on a beautiful day in March. Not really. It's one of these frustrating March days when you want it to be warm, you want the spring to come, and it's awful, it's cold, it's cloudy, it's rainy, it's not nice. But I'm here because we're talking about miracles. These are the last couple videos I'm doing. And miracles are everyday occurrences that we tend to overlook. Here's an example. These are called snowdrops. So in the middle of this yucky weather, the first flowers appear. Snowdrops. How does that happen? That these flowers come up even in these awful conditions. It's something we can't really explain. It's kind of a miracle. You can say, oh, that's what nature does, and that's the clock of the earth and what have you, but really, why does that happen? I think it's a miracle. If we start to look for miracles, we find them. They're all around us. We don't notice them because we go around in our little ego bubble and don't think about them. But when you're sick in the hospital or even dying, they happen. Here's an example. I'm going to get into a more pleasant environment to tell you about it.
Just like me, they long to be close to you. Why do stars fall down?
It's not my favorite song, but that's okay. It's many people's favorite song. And just suppose it was the favorite song of you and your lifelong partner, your significant other. And just suppose that significant other was in the hospital, dying. And you were driving to the hospital all anxious because you had gotten a phone call nobody wants to get. And you're driving and this song comes on. And it's your favorite song. So this song makes you feel better. That's what somebody told me happened to them. Actually, I had two of these experiences as a chaplain in a hospital where people told me that they were driving to the hospital and they heard a special song that was their favorite song and their partner's favorite song.
This was a scenario where they were deciding on whether to go forward with a procedure.
Yeah.
And it was a pretty major one, you know, and they left the hospital, and on the radio was the song they had just been, it was their mother's favorite song. And they had just been in the hospital, like, playing that with her. And when they turned the radio on, there was the song. So they took that as the sign that they should go forward.
What do you think that was?
Oh, I think it's synchronicity. I think it's divine intervention talking to us.
Anybody who has worked in a hospital or hospice knows that these types of stories are commonplace, or not exceptional at all. My story I began earlier is even better than I indicated. So I was called to meet the husband of the person who died, and he told me all this. He told me he was on the way to the hospital, and he was on the phone with someone when the phone call dropped. And this song came on the radio after the call dropped, Close to You by the Carpenters. Don't you love that stuff? I do. his wife had told him earlier that she would stay around him and she would be his angel. She had said that. I almost forgot to add that the husband and the wife were very poor. They could not even afford, or he could not even afford a funeral. And the social worker and I were helping him with finding affordable funeral options. So to me, that makes this even more poignant. When she was being intubated, which means she had a breathing tube inserted in her throat to help her breathe, she told him, she must have written this out, but maybe she told him later, that she saw light coming down, a golden light coming down into her chest. And she heard voices, she heard music, she heard people speaking in a language that she did not understand. And there seemed to be some sort of party going on. This is also a recurring theme in miracle stories from the hospital, that there's a party going on. It's a party for you. And when you're ready, when it's your time, join the party. Are these things coincidences? You know, I leave it up to you. Obviously, I don't think so, and Peggy doesn't think so. But the point of all these videos is to perhaps get you to open your mind just a little bit and give it the benefit of the doubt. Because if your mind opens to admit the possibility that things that we can't explain and events of wonder, miracles, are everyday occurrences. And when you start to admit that thought, everything looks different. The world is a miracle. The world is something to be grateful for. The world is a place of love, a place where things are not the grim, awful ordeal that we are educated to think that it is. Synchronicity happens. Miracles happen. And angels are around us. The stories that I'm relating and others can relate, if you ask, hopefully will open your mind a little bit more to that. That's all for today. Please like and subscribe. Helps me a lot. It's kind of a miracle that people are watching me and they like videos, and I appreciate it. Thank you so much. I'm so grateful. This is Chaplain Greg Holden. I wish you peace.